Hello, and thanks for joining me on the Healing Streams. The title for today's post is A 7-Day Fast. A 7-Day Fast. In Mark chapter 9, verses 14 to 29. The Bible says, "And when he came to the disciples, he saw a great multitude around them, and scribes disputing with them. Immediately, when they saw him, all the people were greatly amazed, and running to him, greeted him. And he asked the scribe, 'What are you discussing?' Then one of the crowd answered, 'Teacher, I brought you my son, who has a mute spirit. And whenever it seizes him, it throws him down. He foams at the mouth, gnashes his teeth, and becomes rigid. So I spoke to your disciples that they should cast it out, but they could not.' He answered him and said, 'Oh, faithless generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him to me.' Then they brought him to him, and when he saw him, immediately the spirit convulsed him, and he fell on the ground and wallowed, foaming at the mouth. So he asked his father, 'How long has this been happening to him?' And he said, 'From childhood. And when he has thrown him both into the fire and into the water to destroy him. But if you can do anything, if you can do anything, have compassion on us and help us.' Jesus said to him, 'If you can believe, all things are possible to him who believes.' Immediately, the father of the child cried out and said with tears, 'Lord, I believe, help my unbelief.' When Jesus saw that the people were running together, he rebuked the unclean spirit, saying to him, 'Death and dumb spirit, I command you, come out of him and enter him no more.' Then the spirit cried out, convulsed him greatly, and came out of him, and he became as one dead, so that many said, 'He is dead.' But Jesus took him by the hand and lifted him up, and he arose. And when he had come into the house, his disciples asked him privately, 'Why could we not cast it out?' So he said to them, 'This kind can come out by nothing but prayer and fasting.'" Prayer and fasting. I'm also reading from 1 Chronicles chapter 10, verse 8 to 12. And it reads, "So it happened the next day when the Philistines came to strip the slain, that they found Saul and his son fallen Mount Gilboa, and they stripped him and took his head and his armor and sent word throughout the land of Philistine to proclaim the news for the temple of their idols and among them. Then they put his armor in the temple of their gods and fastened heads in the temple of Dagon." Verse 11, "And when all Jabesh Gilead heard all that the Philistine had done to Saul, all the valiant men arose, took the body of Saul and the bodies of his sons, and they brought them to Jabesh and buried their bones under the tamarisk tree, Jabesh. and fasted 7 days. And fasted 7 days. Beloved in Christ, this is a challenging moment, especially when we mention when 7 days fasting is mentioned in Scripture. God in Scripture strategically speaks to His people through numbers. The number seven is a reference in the Bible 735 times. And seven in God's number is God's number of completion and spiritual perfection. As we fast for 7 days, we enter into a season of completion in God. This is a season of spiritual completeness. Our life changes over 7 years. Every human being goes through 7 year cycles. It is a number that has to do with change. Seven means completion. It means perfection. It means it's finished. And it means it is done. In fact, 735 times, the number seven is mentioned in the Bible. The number seven is very important number to God. God worked and finished on the seventh day. It is a pattern and precepts God has put in place for humankind. It is in the order and pattern of God's blessing, especially in Ecclesiastes chapter 1. The Bible says, the Egyptians experienced 7 good years of abundance. 7 good years of abundance and 7 bad years of economic recession. So we also have 7 feast days and 7 candlesticks in the inner court. God told the Israelites to march around indestructible wall of Jericho, which has become a barrier to Israel's success. Eventually, it was brought down and conquered by the city of Jericho. Now, in 1 Kings chapter 6, Solomon built the temple of God and completed it on the 7th year to the glory of God. In 2 Kings chapter 5, Naaman was told by Elisha to bathe 7 times and come up out of the water with perfection. Naaman's restoration as a result of his latter obedience activated the patterns and seasons of God in his life. Now, anything which is like a leprosy in your life will go away through your obedience. Elijah prayed 7 times in 1 Kings chapter 18, and there was an abundance of rain. He saw the sound of abundance of rain coming. Also, the 3 Hebrew boys were thrown into the burning fire. And the Bible says the fire was heated 7 times. So this is a period of fasting that will pave the way for you to come out of fiery furnace of problems. So please, I want you to take note of some of the fiery furnace of problems that we go through. Jesus had 7 sayings at Calvary. And on the 7th one, he said, "It is finished." God is setting you up to finish what he started in your life. It is done. God is saying it is time for him to finish what he has begun in your life. As you wait upon him, fast and then meditate on the word of God. Jesus tells Peter to forgive anyone who offends him 77 times. So the Bible also mentions in the book of Revelations of the seven churches in Asia Minor with the seventh angel bringing to pass what God had finished. The type of fasting, this type of fasting, the 7 days type of fasting is going without food and giving up on a variety of things to seek the perfect will of God in a given situation. Some do a strict water-only fast. For instance, Paul fasted and was a man of intense and frequent prayer. After the death of Saul and Jonathan in battle, the people of Jabesh Gilead fasted 7 days. And when the mighty man of God heard about the death of Saul and his son, they also mourned, wept, and fasted, as 1 Corinthians chapter 10, 8 to 12 tells us. For instance, if we start fasting for 7 days period concerning a particular need, whether it is healing, whether it is relationship, whether it is barrenness or finances, it means God is going to finish what he has started in your life. Now, the Bible says when the days of the voice of the seven angels, when he shall begin to sound the majesty of God, it will be finished. In other words, God said, when you get to the season of seven, I am going to finish what I've started. There is another special of seven. It means it is done. The scripture says in Revelation 16, 17, and the seventh angel poured out his vital into the air. And there came a great voice out of the temple of heaven. He poured his veil into the air. And there came great voice out of the temple of heaven from the throne saying, it is done. So it is our time to respond to what God is doing, what God has done. And we will be perfected in our faith and perfected in our finances. Now, Christian walk with the Lord is our help. It is a season when God gives you instruction that it is going to be finished. Jesus said, seven sayings, as I said, on Calvary, which brought deliverance. And the seventh one is, it is finished. It is done. Completion of seven. Philippians 1, 6 says, being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. So Philippians 1 and 6 equals 7 says, the thing that I started, I am confident in this one thing, that which I started, I also finish and further execute and complete it. Indeed, we are serving a God whose name is Alpha and Omega, and this shows that God is a God of patterns, that the patterns of God had been established long before revelation was given to man. Beloved, I pray that the living God will empower you, will give you insight into the things of God in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Then the second part of this prayer and fasting for 7 days has a new dimension. The reason being that everything in the very beginning has a cycle. Man has a cycle. For every 7 years, we go through change. Any doctor will tell you every 7 years we go through change. And there are 7 bones in our neck. You know, God has purposely put these 7 in order for us to look at. And He is trying to tell us, this is how I operate. I operate in seasons. I operate in 7s. 7 years. Now the Bible says there is going to be 7 painful years, a plentiful years, and 7 years of famine. Again, 7 plentiful years and 7 years of famine. Now when we start fasting 7 days according to scripture, then we enter into a pattern of God blessing. Now the book of Ecclesiastes says, if you want to know the future, you have to look to a pattern that which is being is that which will be, and that there is a cycle to everything. So the order of God has already been set. The pattern too has already been set. So such 7 days fasting is a fasting of finishing, completion. It is done, spiritual perfection. Now, during the fast, God began to reverse treasures. God began to release treasures into your life that has to be in order. Now, what is a setup in your life will become, what is a setback in your life will become a setup in your life. As God will arrange things given in order for His pattern to finish as done. Now, it is interesting that Job got double back when the devil stole everything. Now the day Job got it back, he sat in sackcloth 7 days and 7 nights. And then on the 7th day, the 2 friends of Job, they gave 7 rams and 7 bullocks. When they gave back, God turned the captivity of Job around. He said, God gave him double everything that the enemy has stolen from him. Now, in a sense, it is your time for God to finish your need. He began in your life. There is a completion that is going to take place. They gave the 7 rams and the 7 bullocks. And it was finished that they had been through. Again, the 7 rams and the 7 bullocks catapult them to finish what they had been through. Beloved, God says, I am going to do something in your life. But you need to step up and do something like the little boy who with two fishes and five loaves, which equals seven. And at the end of the day, he walked away with 12 baskets. And 12 means government of order. Thus, order is coming to your situation, my dear brother, my dear sister. Order is coming to your situation. And God is going to finish what you have started out to do. So this miracle of multiplying two fishes and seven loaves means multiplication of supernatural increase came. You see, the supernatural increase is coming to you. And I prophesy in the name of Jesus to receive it in Jesus' name at this hour of your life transition through the matchless name of our Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.